My only aim in life is that every child is free to be a child, free to grow and develop, free to eat, sleep, and see daylight, free to laugh and cry, free to play and learn, free to go to school, and above all, free to dream. I have the privilege of working with many courageous people who have the same aim. We have never given up against any threat or attack, and we will never. We had made progress in a couple of years, couple of decades. We have reduced the number of out-of-school children by half. We have reduced the number of child laborers by a third. We have reduced child mortality, malnutrition, and we have prevented millions of child deaths. But let us make no mistake, the great challenges still remain. Friends, the biggest challenge or the biggest crisis knocking on the doors of humankind are fear and intolerance. We have utterly failed our children in imparting an education that gives the meaning and objective of life, an education that gives a sense of global citizenship among youth. I'm afraid that the day is not very far when the cumulative result of all this failure will culminate in an unprecedented violence, and that will be suicidal for the humankind. Rights, security, hope can only be restored through education. Young people like Malala, I started calling her my daughter Malala, not just Malala. So my daughter Malala and other daughters, including Kainath, in fact two Kainaths, and Shazia, and the daughters from Africa and from all over the world. They are rising up and choosing peace over violence, tolerance over extremism, and courage over fear. The solutions are emerging. But these solutions cannot be found in the deliberations, in conferences alone. And cannot be found in the prescriptions from a distance. They lie in small groups and local organizations and individuals who are confronting with the problems every day. Even if they remain unacknowledged, unrecognized, and unknown to the world, the solutions are with them.